to begin discussions on proposed changes to the charter's economic provisions. Velasco said the proposed amendments would relax some provisions and help the Philippine economy be more competitive with its neighbors. Velasco assured the public of fair and transparent debates. The speaker also hopes the House will conclude debates before the year ends, so the amendments would be ratified before the 2022 national elections. And joining us now on Hot Copy to discuss these proposed economic amendments, we have Chair of the House Ways and Means Committee, Albay Representative Joey Salceda. Congressman Joey, good morning to you and a Happy New Year.
Yeah, long time no see.
And a Happy New Year. All right, let's start first with why now? I mean, this is not the first attempt, but you also have some observers saying we are in the middle of a pandemic. Shouldn't that be prioritized? And frankly, also the 2022 elections are coming. Why rush this? Why not let the next administration handle it?
Every administration makes this attempt to change what we can call really, if you look at the OECD, the Philippines is one, in fact, is at the top, the most restrictive economy in the world. So sumusunod lang sa atin is Indonesia. So we really have to make an attempt. You know, we are now in the, what we call, pagpandating po ng mga vaccine, we have to face what we call the economic impacts of the pandemic. So one of the things that could help us, since the pandemic has used up a lot of the, what you can call discretionary cash flows of the nation, of the economy. Kasi parang you crater the economy, I think we will average about negative 7% and grow, quite recover. But I think one way really of offsetting to disallow the economic impact of the pandemic to be more permanent, you need the inflow, exogenous inflows, and these are foreign direct investments.
All right. But if that's the case, if the real goal of this is to attract foreign investors, wasn't that the very purpose of CREATE? That's why CREATE was passed.
Pero yung CREATE provides incentives, pero that is, you're giving up revenues, so that those foreign revenues will essentially, but yung CREATE does not allow industries to go into these industries that are restricted by the Constitution.
All right. So let's focus on what specific economic provisions.
Ito lang.
Okay.
Natural resources, essentially mining and forestry.
Okay.
Pero ang nature po niyan is ngayon, the government can go into what you can call contracts kasi it belongs to the state. Mm. And the state means forever. So, pero dito, inaallow ng 25-year renewable for 25, including mining, forestry, etc.
For foreigners, go ahead. Can you be more specific?
Pero sa Constitution mismo, 60-40. Pero may mga malalaking mina tayo na hindi kakayanin po ang share ng 40 ng Pilipino. Halimbawa, it's a $1 billion. So the Filipinos have to come up with 400. Mm-hmm. And that's essentially 20 billion. So who will take the risk? Mm-hmm. So domestically, baka mahirapan po, makaputa po nung 40% share. So kailangan po, taasan na lang pwede natin bigay sa Kongreso. Because the general thing here is that it gives, like sinabi mo kanina, pandemic. You don't have a pandemic every year. Mm. So basically, now is the time, for example, na to allow certain flexibility to Congress. So it's the entire all seven amendments essentially puts unless provided for by law. So virtually, the amendments are to seven provisions put unless provided for by law.
All right. But can you please specify the seven amendments?
Number one is Dandan Tres, which is Section 2 under Article 12. lands of public domain under Section 3 of Article 12, virtually for Article 12, Section 7, which is private land, Section 10, business in general, kasi may negative list to tayo, so businesses, so lahat sila under 6040, unless provided for by law. Public utilities, ngayon under 6040. Section 4 is under Article 14, which is education, allowing more international schools, especially under the, kasi ngayon po, we are now right into the fourth industrial revolution. And number 7 is on media and advertising, which is 100% Filipino, okay, under Article 16, Section 11.
Uh-oh. So in with these areas for amendments, I wanted to ask you, will they be in each particular area, will there be specific changes per area, or will, because you have both houses essentially just adding the phrase unless otherwise provided by law. Will it be that simple? It's just that?
Yes, and no politics, and only 7.
Okay, so if it's no politics, no less than Senate President Tito Soto had said the president told him personally that he wants amendments when it comes to the party list law. So for example, what about the party list section wherein the president said it's abused by unmarginalized groups and groups calling for the fall of the government?
I think it has to, if you read the original law, kasi ni-revise ng SC, Supreme Court, ni-revise din ng definition ng COMELEC, all it needs is actually legislation. So no need to change the constitution.
Okay. So when it comes to the party list, no need to include it in the conversation when it comes to charter change.
The position of the House is really just to amend the law that defines, kasi provided for by law yun.
Okay. But what if the president pushes this? What if Malacanang pushes this?
Then we will file the bill that essentially defines or clarifies what the party list system is in practice.
So it's essentially a clarification. It's not technically to abolish the party list system. It's a clarification. Now, what about lifting term limits? You do have some sectors that are cynical about this whole practice and believe that the intent is all about really lifting term limits.
Wala pang nakagawa niyan.
So wala.
All of them pirma, I don't know yung kay Arab Concord. Lahat sila, they failed. I can start from Arab, Gloria, kahit kay Nino, yung meron 16th Congress, then 17th and 18th Congress ngayon. Lahat sila, they have. And I have this comparative of all the changes in the position from on all attempts at changing the constitution. So we are probably, this will succeed because it's limited really to only 7 sections, and all of them are economic.
So just 7, but you have that guarantee, coming from the supermajority as well, and even from the speaker.
Si Speaker kasi mismo ang principal author. If you look at it in July 19, that was his first act. Yung kanya pong pagbukas po ng Kongreso noong 2019, that was his, it is one of his first bills. This REH, Resolution of Both Houses number 2.
Okay, just to be specific, because I have messages coming in when it comes to Article 12, I think the business sector wants something more specific than this. When it comes to nature and forestry, one question here is, for example, mining. Will this mean that a Filipino partner would still be needed if this particular change becomes successful?
It's up to Congress, unless provided for by law. So We now have pending in Congress a fiscal regime for mining industry, which mm-mm. was required before mining can be new mining concessions can be given. Mm-mm. So, but I think what can be given really is the law. Congress can enough can change the 60-40 rule.
Oo. So, but there still needs to be a portion for Filipino citizens. Or are you actually saying that if this is passed, foreigners or foreign companies can come in and completely own it without having to have a Filipino partner?
My sense is, I think, one, kasi parang legislation na yan eh. Mm-mm. So it's up to Congress to look at the options that can be given in this particular area, especially mm-hmm. in what you call the natural resource sector.
So I think this is important to discuss essentially the amendment of otherwise provided by law. In amending these seven sections does not mean you will go into great detail in this particular debate. Not yet.
It's Congress now. So yeah. You elect the people you want that, for example, if you want 100% Filipino, then you don't vote for me.
Mm. No, but that will not be discussed, that specific detail, when amendments come. Is that what you're saying, Congressman? Not yet. Not in this Congress.
This Congress, and Congress is elected by the people. So, no,
so ang tanong ko, so isasama na yun? Ganun ba yun? Alam.
Hindi na.
Yun na nga.
Hanggang unless provided for by law.
Okay. So, another question. For example, lands of public domain and private land. In other ASEAN countries, you do have foreigners leasing land for like 99 years. They put up an office, they put up a business. It's 99 years. It's leased. Is that envisioned here?
Actually, yung kay Speaker hindi, pero isa po yan sa mga iniingi kong amendments dun sa final Speaker na RBH na dapat, pati po yung timing, dapat unless provided for by law.
Oo. So, kasi
dun sa dalawang provision na yun, Section 3, Section 7, Article 12, ang pinapakialaman lang niya ay yung 60-40 rule.
Oo, yun not lang. Pero kasi in terms of attracting more business, that would be one, no? In Thailand, for example, or other ASEAN countries, you have them at 99 years. I think some have said 50 is too short if you're essentially investing in the country. So that's one aspect. When it comes to private land, this is easier to understand, but you also have fears of you may have wealthy Chinese, for example, nationals owning all of expensive property in Makati or Quezon City. Paano po yun? Where is the boundary there?
Actually, yung sabi ni Jerry Sikat, pwede daw to yung idle lands outside NCR.
Ah.
So it's up to this is the advice of Jerry Sikat. Oh, pero unless provided for by law, again, ang sagot sa'yo.
Oh, so it's not as simple as just what's enumerated. There could be several conditions when, like for example, private land. It's those outside NCR to spur
pwedeng
development.
Ganun.
Pwedeng ganon.
Pero it's up to Congress to put, not for the Constitution. Because okay. It's up to Congress.
Yes.
Because under the Constitution naman, sinasabi that Congress is the chief policy-making body of the country.
Yeah, oo. Now, with business in general, I mean, with the Public Service Act, I remember speaking to former NEDA chair Ernie Pernia, and he already said they were baby steps, but they were good steps to already open up these restrictive industries. And the Public Service Act, I think, was the first. When you say business in general, okay, public utilities, that's a given. But what specifically in public utilities?
Sa public utilities ngayon kasi naka 60-40. Generally, telecoms.
Oo.
Nasa 60-40 pa rin yun.
Pero ang power, hindi na yun, no? Ang power is no more. Not power.
Power 60-40 pa rin.
I see. Okay.
whether distribution, generation, and transmission.
All right, so you have power, telecom, and water. I'm presuming you're including.
Yes. Uh-oh.
And what were the suggestions, I mean, generally speaking, when it comes to that? A possibility of full foreign ownership?
I think that the sense is, kasi may mga malalaking, nakita mo naman yung TR4,
yeah,
yung mula dito sa Santo Tomas, pupunta Lucena. In-approve yun natin, 1996.
Okay.
Ngayon, nagsisimula pa lang ngayon na 2020. You just imagine, it took what, 24 years?
Yeah.
Kasi nga, sa kakulangan ng kapital. So kung ngayon na may cash flow na po si RSA, kaya na nagagawa na po niya.
Mm-hmm.
So essentially, depende po yan sa mga project profile, lalo-lalo sa pangangailangan. So it's up to each Congress depending on the needs or the requirements of the economy for growth and for equity to determine what is a mix. So they can have a variation in by industry also, for one.
Mm-mm. Okay. Joey, when I last spoke with you, you said you estimate that CREATE would turn in $6 billion, did you say dollars or pesos, no? In foreign investments.
Yes.
Pesos?
Opo.
Okay. That would add 6 billion pesos in foreign investments. And I remember you said maybe an additional 1 million jobs.
Yes.
If these amendments are implemented, what do you envision? Yeah, presuming and it's done well.
Assuming walang CREATE. Okay? Halimbawa, wag na muna yung CREATE. Pag ito lang, on its own, sa GDP, average of 1.85%.
A year. Okay.
Average sa capital formation, 6.5. Sa FDI, yun, mga $5 billion.
Other than CREATE.
Ay, $7 billion. Kasi marami tayong nirestrict eh.
Uh-oh.
Kaya ibig sabihin, alos kalahati. Halimbawa, nilagyan mo ng 60-40 rule. So hindi po ang capital na kailangan ay napakalaki. Sa pagdating po sa wages, average po is 1.66%. Real wages ay hindi nominal wages.
Uh-oh.
So positive 1.85 additional on steady state. Pero ito, so pag pinagsabay mo to at saka ang CREATE, makikita mo na ma-offset natin. One, you can offset everything na that was, you prevent the crater created by COVID. At the same time, ma-offset mo dahil hindi po tayo nagkaroon ng malaking stimulus. And structurally, for the long term, we need this.
Oo. Okay. And then education, that actually it's good, frankly, for the future generations.
For industrial revolution po yan eh.
Yeah.
Kasi
yeah.
Yung mga Silicon Valley, alam mo yung buong Silicon Valley was created simply because of the scientists that were trained by Stanford.
Yeah.
That Silicon Valley was essentially created by Stanford scientists.
Okay.
It's
good that you clarify that these seven areas I don't know if you can actually hold on, if people can hold on to your word that congressman will not touch any other part of the Constitution.
Actually, si Speaker, we'll be meeting all the heads of the parties. I think today or tomorrow. Para magkaroon ng agreement na wag na muna yung politics kasi ang daming permutations yun eh.
Mm-mm.
So, unang-una, pangalawa, maraming motivations.
Mm-mm.
So, pero ito naman, halos may consensus na po na economic provisions.
Mm-mm.
Except of course, the Makabayan Bloc. So, we expect debates really and clarification from the majority, but of course, from the Makabayan Bloc, they will oppose. Especially po dito sa public domain and private land at saka NatRes.
Okay.
Yung first 1, 2, 3. Yung section 2, section 3, section 7.
Okay. All right. Now, the speaker is giving it a year of debates. Over in the Senate, you already have, I think, Senator Bato de la Rosa and Senator Tolentino, they filed a resolution already calling for a constituent assembly. They did that last December 7. So what are you seeing in terms of that?
Parehas lang to. So kung, in fact, ito essentially, parang constituent assembly din to, kasi kailangan approved by 3/4 of Congress.
Mm-mm.
3/4 ng House, 3/4 ng... Ibig sabihin, kailangan ng 228.7, ibig sabihin, so 289 na congressman at saka 16 na senador.
Okay, so if it's just to insert the phrase unless otherwise provided by law, why will this take a year? I mean, I'm just curious.
If the Democrats can impeach Trump in one day, in one week. So I guess, I think it's really to allow the people to have a clearer, it's more for clarifying what are the impacts. Mm-hmm. Kasi dito, ginagamitan ko data science tool like dynamic stochastic general equilibrium. I'm sorry, this is called DSGE.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't put number two, what is the impact on the economy?
Mm-hmm.
Essentially, in terms of GDP.
Mm.
So, sa first year nito, 329 billion kahit walang create.
Sa first year, basta may amendments? And you mean by 2022, mararamdaman na ang 329 billion?
Opo. Sa first year, 2021 ba ngayon, 118 billion.
Okay, go on. Without create, 118 billion in 2021 increase in revenue.
No, in foreign direct investments.
In FDIs. But how could you measure that already? Do you already have parties that have expressed interest?
I think sa BOI at saka sa PES, pero yung PESA kasi they provide the land then, di ba? So, but ang nakaka-restrict sa kanila yung 60-40 rule. So yung tinatawag natin yung business in general, pati po sa public utilities. Doon naman sa public utilities, talaga habol natin, buksan natin yung mga, lalo-lalo na yung tubig, lalo-lalo na po yung sanitation, tapos yung sewage, at tapos kasi yung sa sewage, wala na sa 10% pa lang tayo.
Yeah. So 2021, 118 billion increase in FDIs. When it comes to 2022, 369 billion increase.
329
in FDIs. Okay. All right. Is there anything you'd like to add, Congressman Joey? I'd like to have you again to be able to detail this as you go along when you have your debates.
Opo. Kaya nga si Speaker nag-provide po na between now until the end of the year. Para po hindi naman po pressured yung iba. Pero I think mas sabi ko na eh, mas gusto ko we will have our first hearing on Wednesday.
Okay.
It is chaired by Congressman Gardine. I was assigned essentially by the speaker directly to help him defend. Ibig sabihin, dapat hindi na masyado. We will stick to the 7 and then to essentially ma-explain po sa taong bayan kung bakit economic chacha lang ang ano. So I think there is a very strong case for lifting the economic restrictions. Meron, marami po akong chart dito, pwede ko ipadala sa iyo.
You can send it to me actually, Congressman.
Na there is a direct proportion, that there is direct causation na yung mas liberal ang kanilang FDI policy ay mas mataas po yung FDI at mas mataas po yung growth. Ang case in point lagi is Vietnam.
Mm-mm.
Pero kahit po dito sa atin, makikita mo po na na-overtake po tayo ng Vietnam. Ito.
Oo. Vietnam averages, I think, 20 billion a year in FDIs.
Yeah, dollars.
Yeah.
Itong makukuha natin dito, ang mag-average over 10 years is about $7 billion.
Mm.
Pero pag tinignan mo itong chart na to, Makikita mo na na-overtake tayo ng Vietnam.
Yeah.
Yung right after na we na in-approve natin yung 1987 Constitution.
Mm. So what you're really making a case that it is the restrictions.
Opo, kasi kahit gaano ka incentive mo, I mean, I give a lot of incentive, but you cannot give an incentive to
something that's not allowed.
I mean, I would say that 30% of the entire GDP is off limits to foreigners. Ang laki-laki nun, e, buksan mo lang yun, kahit di mo bigyan ng incentive, I mean, there is a case for them to diversify, like what happened when the Europeans and the U.S. diversified mm-hmm. out of China. Mm-hmm. Lahat napunta sa Vietnam.
Mm-hmm.
So, gawa na mas open sila. Ang Cambodia, halos, you can second only to, I think, Singapore in terms of openness to foreign investments.
Yeah. Okay. So, all right. Well, Congressman Joey Salceda, I hope to talk with you again. And I think you made you coined an interesting term, economic chacha lang. That's what you said. Economic chacha lang.
Eh, siyempre, pinakaris dito, singit.
Oh, pero yun lang, no? Yun lang. Wala nang pwede isingit. Actually, kung may isingit, it's bound to fail.
Ah, oo. Automatic.
Mm.
Mm. Kaya i-separate natin. Pero pang nakita, kumbaga, it's not a baby step. It is a major structural change but where people would have probably greater understanding.
Mm.
Mas maintindihan nila dahil walang motivation. Ibig sabihin, unless provided for by law. So yung next Congress, nasa kanila po yan. Or future Congress, up to them, based po sa need ng country. So at least it gives Congress as the chief policy-making body under the Constitution, the flexibility of essentially making changes.
Mm.
The alternative here is charter change to parliamentary. Diba?
Yeah, so, but then by discussing that, then you have a whole other problem.
Oh, yun nga. So, at saka wala namang appetite na eh. Kasi gawa-gawa naman Dana's ruling eh. So,
correct.
You make all those political changes. So, right now, the appetite for political structural change, although it's also needed, ako, I agree. Open ako dyan. Pero for the sake of at least getting this first, alam mo ba na tayo ang pinakamahabang constitution sa buong mundo?
Mm.
Pinakamahaba by the number of letters. Second lang sa atin is India. Hindi ko sinasabi yan. Parang halos na-write na nasulat natin. Well, during that time kasi, di ba, yung coalition that built up in order to install CORI, of course, there was a strong, what you can call, leftist, how would I say that? If you have a spectrum between right and left, there are more left.
Okay. All right. My last question, Congressman Joey, my last question is professors asking right now, watching you, what should stop Congress from touching other sections of the charter? Perhaps an assurance, this is a professor from a respected university.
Pag nilagyan nila ng politics ito, goodbye.
Oo, yun na yun. Pag nilagyan ng politics, goodbye.
If you put politics into RBH2, dead on arrival.
Okay.
Para ka na COVID. In 6 days, patay ka.
Okay, on that note, Congressman Joey Salceda, it's always such a pleasure to speak with you. A happy new year, sir. I'll get back with you again soon.
Thank you. You always get me into trouble.
No, thank you. Thanks, Congressman Joey.
Thank
God bless you. You stay strong. We're